things were always happening to us.
Oh, your characters.
Just like this.
So anyhow, we went down to Miami and asked the real estate man to show us our lot. He pointed out in the bay and he said, you see that rowboat? It's anchored on your lot.
We thought we were going to be millionaires. Oh, here's Lucy.
Well, it's about time.
Well, let's go.
Flo, I'm sorry, I'm not ready yet.
Well, honey, Mrs. Stromble is with little Ricky. Let's
honey,
go.
Honey, it'll only be a minute. My nails aren't dry.
Well, I'm hungry.
Come on, now, sit down. Tell another story, Fred.
Oh, well, all right. Rick, did I ever tell you what happened to Ethel and me on our honeymoon?
Not lately.
Did I tell you, Lucy?
Yes. I was there.
Oh, my God.
Hey, you know, speaking of funny things that happen to people, Lucy, you remember the musician's picnic last 4th of July?
Oh, what a day that was.
What happened?
Oh, well.
I'll tell it, dear.
Oh, okay.
The musician's local was having a picnic, see?
And it was for charity. You know, you paid so much money, and half of it went for charity, and half of it went for the picnic.
That's right. And all the boys in the band wanted to go. So Marco and Alberto and Pepin and Joe, Jokul and Ralph, everybody was going down there. So we left about 10 o'clock.
It was 12 o'clock.
No, dear, it was 10 o'clock.
No, honey, it was 12 o'clock.
Well, what's the difference?
2 hours.
I mean, to the story, it doesn't make any difference.
Yes, it does, dear. That's the reason we were late. That's why... Well, it's your story. Go ahead.
Thank you. Well, we got to the picnic
don't
grounds.
About the cars.
What was that?
I said, don't forget about the cars, dear.
The cars. Yeah, that's right. We took 3 cars. Lucy and I were in the first car. Pepin was in the second car. Marco was in the last car.
Oh, honey, you're ruining everything.
Would you like to tell the story?
No, dear. You're the storyteller in the family, but I just want you to get it right. Now, Pepin was in the first car, Marco was in the second, and we were in the last.
Maybe Pepin was in the first car, and you were in the second, and Marco was
Fred.
In the last. Well, it was the only combination left.
Okay, I take it all back. We all took the same bus.
Coward.
Anyway, we got to the picnic grounds about 2 o'clock.
Don't look at me. I'm not going to say anything more.
Good.
I'm not going to tell you what you left out.
Anyway, we got to the picnic grounds about... What did I leave out?
Nothing. Go on with the story.
Well, it feels like there's something missing there someplace. You sure?
Positive.
All right. Well, we spread the food out, and it started to rain.
Oh, it poured.
So we took everything, and we ran to the cars. And then when we got there...
Yeah, yeah, what happened?
What's the matter, Ricky?
What did I leave out?
Nothing. I was just kidding you. Now go on.
Well, I'm telling you, it feels like there's something missing there someplace.
Oh, what's the difference? Go on and finish it.
Well, oh, the heck with it. It's not funny anymore. Come on, let's go and have dinner. Come on.
Well, all right. My nails are dry now. Let's go to that place on 45th Street.
Oh, I hear they have wonderful steaks.
Well, I don't particularly feel like
steak
a steak.
Sounds wonderful. We'll go there.
Now, wait just a minute, Lucy.
What's the matter?
Well, I just had about enough of this. First, you keep everybody waiting while you're fixing your nails. Then you keep interrupting me while I'm telling the story. And now you decide all by yourself where we're going to eat dinner because you want a steak.
Well, Ricky,
I don't feel like eating steak tonight. I want to eat spaghetti tonight.
Well, maybe...
So we're going to eat spaghetti.
Yes, sir.
And the next time that I tell a story, you stay out of it.
Yes, sir.
And be on time from now on, or we're going to go without you.
Yes, sir.
We're gonna run this house like we do in Cuba, where the man is the master and the woman does what she's told.
Si, senor.
And don't get smart. Now go get your coat.
Oh, yeah?